everybody and welcome to my channel, or welcome back to my channel. Today, you guys, we're going to be talking about an area of the face that is so problematic for so many people. We're going to be talking about the eyes. So we're going to be talking about the darkness under the eyes. We're going to be talking about droopy eyelids. So we're going to be talking about all of the problems in that area. The reason why in general we get darkness under the eyes, puffiness under the eyes, why we get that kind of fluid buildup there, it is very much connected with your neck, your scalp. It connected with so many other areas of your body, not just your eyes. Of course, it very much depends on how much sleep you get, how much tension you feel. Is there any kind of spasmed and tension going on around your neck area, around your scalp area, especially at the bottom of your scalp, also around your jaw and your chewing muscles? So all of this is very much connected. So I always recommend thinking about it as a problem that needs different methods and different approaches, and not just one. So we're going to be doing a little bit of neck massage, a little bit of tension release there, scalp, and then we're going to move into the face and work around the eye area as well. So this will help to depuff the area, to help that drainage of the fluids, because a lot of the times when, of course, we are aging, the muscles and that are supporting our eyes are starting to lose their tone, and this is when sometimes you see that the eyes are kind of sinking in. But also it's about the capillaries and the veins that are connected to your eye area, and if that drainage is not happening of the blood flow and through the veins, if it's not happening very well and that drainage is not working very well, then you will get that stagnation, the buildup of the fluid. So we're gonna start with the neck. I recommend either using an oil. You can not use an oil, you can use a cream. So I'm just gonna apply a little bit of my Aurelia oil onto my hands, and then we're gonna start with the neck. So I'm just gonna apply quite a bit onto my neck and onto my chest, and we're just gonna start with knuckling the chest, just warming everything up, because it all starts here. It doesn't just start right there. So I'm just going in circular motions using my knuckles, and then one finger over, one finger under the collarbone. And let me turn around. So I'm gonna stay with my knuckles, and I'm just gonna slide them from under the ears and under the scalp, or under this bone right here. I'm gonna slide it down. And let's just do a bit of a circular movement massage in that area. So if you're feeling tension here, it is very important to work to release that tension in your shoulders, in your neck, to achieve any kind of results that will show up in your eyes. So even if you only have 5 minutes, I would always recommend doing your neck and doing your chest to depuff and to brighten up your eyes. So using your fingers, using your knuckles, let's just stay at the base of the skull. So really find that edge of the bone, the edge of the skull, and massage that area really well using your finger pads. You can do one hand at a time because it really can feel like a workout. Okay, it is also very important to work around the temple muscle. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna start creating little channels. So you can either use two fingers, I like to use both hands, and then we're gonna take it into the hairline. So just folding the skin and taking it all the way into the hairline. So we're gonna use methods like massage, as we're doing now, exercises or face yoga. So this should be a good way if you stick to it and you dedicate your time to it, then you will start seeing results. Doesn't happen in a day, but it is definitely worth it. So we're also massaging the upper neurosis, which is almost like a connective tissue or fascia that is just under your scalp and between your skull. So we want it to be movable. We want it to be flexible. We don't want it to be stagnant. So another thing you can do is grab onto your hair and just massage it a little bit in circular motions. It would be better if my hair was out. But I do this every time in the evening when I brush my hair. So I'm just grabbing onto the hair and massaging it, allowing some movement here. And let's do some exercises. So for the first exercises, I'm gonna make little glasses like this. Hold onto the brow and hold underneath, just so we're not wrinkling anything else. And then you're gonna start squinting with your top lid, with your upper lid. Well done. And then I'm gonna place my hands into peace fingers like this, into the inner and outer corner of the eye. And then I want you to try and squint with the bottom eyelid. About 20 times. And release, fingers go under the, just the end of the brow, lift the brow slightly, and now we're gonna squint with the top eyelids again. Okay, back into the glasses. We're gonna look up for as long as you can. Hold the gaze up. Try not to wrinkle the rest of your face, so try to control all the other muscles. So no frowning between the brows, no crow's feet appearing as you're doing it. And now let's look down. So the hands are just there to support the skin. Make sure we're not frowning. They're just resting, they're not pressing. Let's look to the right. And let's look to the left. And now we're gonna gaze forward and blink fast. About 20 times. And then slow. Back to fast. And slow. And release. Just have a little moment to rest the eyes. Let's go into a little bit of a massage. You can apply some eye cream or you can apply some oil. So I'm just gonna lightly press with my ring finger, go around the circle, and then you can make an O shape with your mouth and go under, over and under, over and under. So the O shape with the mouth just stretches the skin. If you can be very gentle and not create any more folds or wrinkles without making the O shape with your mouth, then you don't have to do that. And let's just relax the circular muscle. So just going over the brow. We're working with deeper tissue here, not just the skin. So try to grab onto the muscle as well. And then we're going to go deeper into the eye, so closer to the eye. So I want you to locate the orbital bone that is surrounding your eye socket. And then we're going to make tiny little movements, pulling the fingertips away from each other. Very, very gently. Super, super gentle in this area. Just gonna do that two times. So just on the edge of the bone. And down the side. Let's just massage around the sinuses. So circular motion from the nostrils up towards the tear duct. If you have any sinuses congestion or you suffer from some allergies, sometimes we get some fluid buildup here. Ah, this just makes me want to close my eyes. And let's do a bit of this. Just scooping the fingertips into the nasal fold, out, and then towards the ears. And let's just do a few sweeps all the way down. And that, my friends, is it. I'm definitely feeling brighter and more awake. I hope you enjoyed this massage. Let me know if you have any questions at all about this massage or any other, if you have any desires or requests for the future ones, just put them in a comment section below and I'll try to keep an eye on them. I hope you're all having a wonderful day. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done that yet. And I will see you guys very soon in my next video. Bye.